You are at the Kennedy Space Center.
Inside of the Kennedy Space Center.
All rockets.
All of the gigantic rockets in the Saturn. 1B right there.
That's right.
Awesome.
Cool. There's the Gemini. This is the Mercury Atlas right here. That's the Mercury Rescue. Yep, they've got the same capsule at the top of them, see?
So nobody went inside of those.
Oh yeah, people went inside of these. They sure did. That's the wrong button, Logan.
What button do I push?
You just hit the emergency escape button.
I did?
Yes. Can you imagine being stuck in here for 2 weeks?
Oh crap. Be an astronaut.
Alright. I'll hop in there.
Here it is in the Apollo. We're facing up to the sky.
Getting ready for launch and launch. Oh, here it's upside down. Okay.
Just like the launch we were in yesterday at Disney World.
So how do we turn it on? Or what button does turn it on?
That's a good question. I think it's, hold on here, let me see.
Oh, here it is.
From generator awesome. Panel, that's on. I think we just tell Siri that we're ready to launch, and I think they just automated for us.
Ready to launch.
All right, good. And then we just kind of sit here and be like, well,
we're screwed.
Here we go.
That is awesome. Cool. Let's go see the Atlantis.
Oh,
okay. Wow. How cool is that, huh?
Wow.
This is it?
Satellite. Huh?
Yeah, that's where the satellite goes. Yeah.
Out of the world's largest space shop, and now we just came out and bought some space junk, and now we're looking at a pure Lego model of, what is it called, Dad?
The Spirit Rover.
The Spirit Rover. It is pure Lego, and every single piece of it is Lego. Lego company built this fuel scale model in 2002 based on images provided by NASA. Overall, the model is a paper proper size and shape with all instruments, components, and structures represented faithfully and to scale. A few small details are not perfectly accurate, as the rover design changed slightly during development. The model weighs 290 pounds, 130 kilograms. The actual rover weight weighs 410 pounds, 185 kilograms. It is made of approximately 90,000 Lego elements, requiring 650 man hours to construct. A 3-month process for the Lego Master Builder team.
That's so neat! Cool.
All right, let's go see an IMAX. Sound good? We had a really good day.
Yeah, we have.
We have.
Space junk.
Space junk. What are we doing now?
Well, we just got done with the movie. It was a good movie. And now we're looking at a whole bunch of space capsules. This is the Dragon spacecraft.
This is what we're going to watch launch tomorrow.
Yeah, I don't know what that one is called or that one.
Look at how hot that got coming in. You can see the burn marks. That. Wow. Cool, huh?
Yeah.
And this is going to be the stuff for the Boeing capsule for the NASA Space Launch System one. That's the really big one.
Oh, are these the same things?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the internal structure of that one. And there is, here, stand in front of that model. Right here.
This is the new. This is a space shuttle and the Saturn V combined.
Yep, that's right. See, that's the little things we saw this morning.
Yeah.
The
tracks.
This is like the mobile launch platform thing.
Yeah, it's cool.
That is cool. Yeah, it is.
It's awesome. The wheels are right here. There's wheels. They're very hard to see, but you can see them. The wheels are right there. It has this tall platform with millions and millions of stairs. It must be a pain in the butt to get up all those stairs. It probably is a lot of them. Then they board right on top of there. They get in, and then they're able to
do
it.
They go.
It's a 3-person craft.
Cool. I think that one's a 7.
No, it's a 3. It has the Saturn V in that. It's a 3-person.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it used the capsule from Saturn V.
Okay.